Hello and welcome to part 2 of Kirby's Adventure. This time we're taking on level 2, which is Ice Cream Island, so here we go. I gotta say, I do love the sort of more tropical theme that this level's got going on, and they sort of do sort of keep those sort of themes throughout the levels. And just a quick heads up, this is another level where there are no sort of secrets throughout the entire world, so no need to worry about those doors not turning white when you exit them. But right, here we have the first of the new abilities in this world. We have Parasol. Now, basically, whilst you have Parasol, anything that's sort of an aerial attack will not do damage to you. It's actually a really useful ability, and I don't want to lose it already. So, here we go. But, yeah, like, these coconuts just falling straight down will do nothing to Kirby. Like, you can sort of just whack it straight forwards like that. And as Kirby's, like, falling through the air, he gains kind of a slow descent. And although I don't want to lose Parasol, I kind of have to show off something. No, I don't, because I ended up defeating that by accident. Whoops. Let's see. I think I might actually keep Parasol over Sword, to be honest, because it is kind of a useful ability, like I've been saying. So, yeah, let's keep that and just defeat all these enemies here. Waddle these and waddle doos. And off goes the Parasol. Right, that was a enemy that also had the crash ability that we got from the mini boss in the last episode. And if that landed on, if that crashed and landed on the ground, then it would have hurt Kirby, basically. So you have to sort of defeat them before they go. And this is like my favorite ability in the game, to be honest, other than one that we will be getting to later, but that's only temporary. This is Tornado Kirby. Basically, just hold down the button, Kirby revs up and starts spinning everywhere. And anytime that you hit enemies during that spin, then they will be damaged. But obviously, towards the end of the animation where Kirby comes out, he's sort of defenseless in the air. So, yeah. Anyway, here's the pause screen. And yeah. But I really love Tornado Kirby just because it gets around and it's really fun to use, even if it's not the most reliable ability to attack with. But here we go. And that was pathetic. Wow. That was really pathetic in terms of getting a bonus. We've got a little minigame to play up here. Ah, the egg catcher minigame. This is kind of a difficult one. Like, we've got King DDD over here. He will be throwing eggs and bombs. You want to hold the button open to eat the eggs, but close it as soon as he throws a bomb. Unlike me there. Now, I got a bonus points there, and the points really do nothing for you. But if you do get far enough in that game, you can earn some 1-ups, so it's actually pretty useful. Here we go for the second level. Oh, and I love this music. I love all the music in this game, really, but like, there's certain tracks that really stand out, like this one. Right, I won't keep that up all the way through this, because that'll get really annoying, but yeah, just defeat a needle enemy. I hate needles and abilities, so. And it looks like we're underwater here, but Kirby doesn't act like it with the physics, so, eh. So now we're apparently going to a desert, and you can, like, if you come across, like, a part in the game where, like, they give you a selection of enemies like this to choose from, it generally means you're coming up to a mini boss, and, like, you should choose one of these to take them on with, so. Considering all that, I'm going to grab Sword and use that throughout here. So let's just grab Sword. And let's take you on. Ah. This is another new ability, mini boss. So let's just slash that a couple of times. Like, for some reason I keep thinking Sword's like gonna stunlock it really well, but ah well. See, this is another one of the more fun abilities in the game. This is Wheel Kirby. I think it is really fun to play as, but not that useful in general. Like, here's a pause screen to give you a quick description, and basically if you hold down the button, Kirby will, well in fact even you don't have to hold it down, just if you press the button, Kirby will turn into a wheel, and you can press the left and right to turn Kirby. You can actually go straight over one block gaps like that. So it's kind of like Mario's running animation, like you can go straight over one block gaps, but the reason why it kind of sucks is you can't jump in this form, and as you're turning, like I was going to do there, you actually become vulnerable for a second, so it's not the most useful ability, but it's still pretty fun, and you can get through areas pretty quickly. But you can see that I'm not that fond of it just because of how defenseless it can leave you sometimes. That was a pretty short level, gotta say. I mean, I know we're only in World 2, but that was pretty damn short. You have another one of those Kirby Crane minigames. Let's see if I can get double 2-ups this time. Right, come on, and release! I think we got pretty... Oh, I was about to say, like, I think we got a pretty good grip on that one, but... Right, let's go for the 2-up again. Go big or go home. And stop. I overshot it. Like, basically, there is sort of like a second or two that the crane will carry on after you release the button, and it's kind of screwed me up there. But like, I swear I'm normally better than this. Damn that recording curse, or that part. That was part of me, obviously, but yeah. Anyway. Level 3. So, you should probably give up the wheel ability here and go straight for parasol, but I was an idiot. Right, let's just drop down in here. So, you think this is one of the more annoying areas in the game, if I remember rightly. Like, I remember there's something familiar... Something kind of annoying about one of these areas. Yeah, I think it's this bit here. I think. If you want to try and hit... Okay, maybe not. I'm thinking of a later area that has a sort of setup like that. Oh, and this... That was... a very rare ability. Let's see if it comes back. No. In fact, because that's kind of like such a rare ability and I want to kind of get the explanation out of it out of the way, I think I'm just going to like restart this level and meet you guys back here. Okay, I'm back to this point in the stage. I've got rid of my sword ability. Now I get to go in here and... God damn it. Well, I guess we're not finding out what this enemy in here does for a little while. But, rest assured, it's one of the best enemies in the game. Well, one of the best abilities to take from them in a game. So, let's just grab sword and be on our way. The sword's pretty damn useful as it is. Alright, let's get going. See, so, you can actually use sword on the water, and pretty much any ability that gives Kirby a weapon of some sort, because there's a couple of those, like sword and... Sorry, like sword and hammer that do so. So, if Kirby actually has, like, a physical item with him, like, as part of his ability, then he will be able to use it underwater and such. I wish I had sword still here, so I could actually use it to get rid of that bomb block and get an extra life from it. Ah well, you gotta deal with what you got, really. So, oh, and that's a. I say that right there is a cappy. You steal its like mushroom cap thing, and it's just another enemy that you have to sort of suck up, or you can use its hat to kill it. Here we have Meta Knight unleashing his Meta Knights. Narcissism, what's that? But anyway, this battle can be kind of annoying just because of like the sheer number of enemies that you got to defeat here, and I've got to be kind of careful here, to be honest. The one that you've really got to watch out for is that one in the top left that like throws sort of like pitchforks or tridents down at you. he can, like, hit you from a pretty large range, to be honest, just because it's sort of an arcing throw, and because he's up there on his own, he tends to get forgotten about fairly easily, so if you just leave him to it, then he can kill you, like, surprisingly effectively. And let's just keep running over here, and through the exit door. And yes, we got the one up! We have Kirby do his little dance with two friends, and get a one up. Thank you. Alright, now, because I had to complete this level to go back around again, we basically unlock the museum as well as level 4. So in this museum we have either laser or fire Kirby, and we haven't had laser yet. And basically Kirby shoots a laser. My one problem with laser Kirby is there's a little bit of a delay after you press the button before he fires it. Like, he needs like half a second to charge up, really. So, yeah. But as you can see from that description there, it's kind of a bouncy weapon, and if there's sort of like slants and stuff, it will bounce straight off them. And some puzzles in this game will actually require you to have a laser Kirby with you to actually complete them. Let's just shoot that. But yeah, laser Kirby's kind of weird, because like I said, that half second delay, like, it doesn't sound like much, but it really does throw you off when you're trying to, you know, aim at enemies and stuff. But I don't like laser Kirby that much, so I'm just getting rid of it and missing. I always like how it says miss when Kirby gets killed. Like, for some reason, that's just... I find that weird that it's just miss! Anyway, once we're through there... That was just a room to get one up, apparently, but... See, that's another thing I haven't really talked about. If Kirby absorbs multiple things at once, or sucks up multiple things at once, whilst, like, I've talked about the mixing and how, like, your power star will overwrite anything else, if you suck up, like, two blocks, for example, like, if we can get both of these, nope, then when Kirby spits out again, it will turn into, like, a mega star thing to shoot out at enemies, so... It's pretty useful, and it does do a lot more damage if you're facing something with a health bar, like a boss or a mini boss. So bear that in mind. Like, if you can absorb multiple things, do. Now you have another new thing here, Stone Kirby. Now, if anyone's played a Super Smash Bros. Series, they will be pretty familiar with Stone Kirby, which is basically the most spammed move with him. But it's pretty effective. Basically, whilst Kirby is in this form, he is invulnerable. Like, if you actually get a chance to use it. But, god damn it, got combo by that guy. Like, I really don't like this mini boss, by the way. Like, I really hate that mini boss. I think he's a bit of a douche, to be honest. Anyway, Fire Kirby is probably a better bet, because Stone Kirby, like I said, if you're familiar with Smash Bros. With Kirby, the only way to use Stone Kirby is to drop down on top of your opponents, and you don't always have an ideal situation for that. Fire Kirby gives you at least a little bit more range to do your damage with it. So, yeah. Anyway, here we have another new ability. This is Mike Kirby, which for some reason is spelled... like the name Mike instead of M-I-C, but oh well. And this is basically like a Crash Kirby in that it's a screen nuke, but instead of just one usage, we get three usage. So yeah. And apparently Kirby's not a very good singer. So use up two uses there, and let's get the third and final. Oh no, I don't want to use the third and final time here. Let's grab laser now. And Kirby shoots it. Bounce off those ramps, and we get an extra one up, which always useful. I supposedly give you Mike Kirby there with three uses, just to sort of say, hey, do you want to use it in this room as well to clear out the enemies? Because no, you don't want to do that there. I think we have another room that has like little bouncy corners for us to use laser on, and we can get that bottle of Coke. So, let's go. And now back out the room. Yeah, Kirby's a pretty much very food orientated game a lot of the time. Like, he will go on entire genocidal massacres just for a piece of strawberry shortcake. And that's actually true to something in the series, look it up. But, yeah, let's go. And, do I get it this time? No. Let's see, what do we unlock? Ah, the arena. So, basically the arena, it's you versus a mini-boss, and if you win, you get the mini-boss's ability. I might actually take, like, although not fond of defensive abilities like freeze, I might actually take it because I'm not really fond of a laser either. Like, say what you want about freeze, at least it's fairly instant. So, yeah. It's still better than needle, so, yeah. Anyway, let's go through door number 5. Let's get running. See, if you can... Like, one of the annoying things is because Shotso's are invincible, like, whilst they're moving around on parasols, which is actually fairly common, you, like, it's kind of difficult to dodge them because you can't, like, do anything to take them out whilst they're in the air. So, yeah. Kind of an annoying thing to do, really. And now let's get Wheel. Oh, got both of them, so we get a mix, and... High Jump Kirby! Okay, so... So you've got Kirby's regular jump, which is the 2-button, but if you press 1 with high jump, boom! Right, I need sort of a lower area to show it off better, but here we go. It's a pretty cool thing, and you can control your trajectory with it, and as you're falling down, when Kirby's stance changes to a sort of face-down thing, Kirby does actually do damage with that, so it's pretty cool. I kind of like high jump, it's sort of awkward to use though, like you gotta have the right situation for it, but anyway, you gotta have a little read about that. I kind of like in later games, like the little get up Kirby gets when he gets a high jump Kirby, like, because he gets like little wings on the side of his head, and he also gets like a little cape as well, which is great. Anyway, right here, we have the worst Kirby ability in the game. I'm just going to wait for this Waddle Dee to get down here, because, see, this is a Kirby ability that actually makes Kirby worse, and I really want to clear out all the enemies on screen before using it, but I couldn't. Like, me wanting to show off everything's really been backfiring so far, but anyway, this is Sleep Kirby. Without controlling it, Kirby just goes right to sleep. I love the pause screen for Sleep Kirby. That's the one good thing about it. Anyway, the reason why there were so many wheel enemies over here is because of like Gordo that was down there that you might have seen. So we'll just pop into Wheel Kirby and go rolling down here. So we'll just hop out of that and wheelie. Yeah, Wheel Kirby can go straight through Gordo's, so that's pretty good. And we'll get to this little door, which gives us some health. And then, if I remember right, this should take us back to the other door. Yeah, it does. So it's kind of useful if you just want a quick health top up. That is not classed as like a secret area for, you know, white door completion. But yeah, it's still useful to know. Also, if you're going through levels like this, be careful of anything in the background like that has a sort of arch shape, because if it's a complete arch, like you can see down there, then it's a doorway you can actually pass through. You can see here we've got 2 fireball enemies, so if you want fireball Kirby, be my guest. Go get it there. And, yeah. kind of sort of getting hit again. Right, so you've got another doorway. Okay, high jump Kirby time. I remember liking this area. Like, yeah, it's kind of cool what they do with like the crash enemies here. Like, I don't know, just find it kind of funny, like, they've set up an entire area solely dedicated to getting rid of crash bomb enemies. Here we go, got extra health there. I'm really looking for an ability, because I don't like sticking as normal Kirby for too long. See, and we get... Nice. Like, not good enough for an extra life, but I'll take it. Right here we have a warp star station. So if we go in here, we can travel back to level 1, straight through that. Or go back to level we're already in, level 2. But obviously, because we're at the boss, we will be unlocking level 3, and the warp star stations will be useful once we've got multiple balls going. I'm going to get Fire Kirby, just because it's the best sort of ability we can get from here, in my opinion. See, there are some bosses in the game where you can only use certain abilities, and right here we have the artist here that I can't remember the name of, but basically whatever she draws comes to life. And I'm not sure she's the same character, the one that appears in Kirby 64, I'll have to look that up again. But basically whatever she draws comes to life and can hurt you, but a lot of her stuff can also like give you an ability if you swallow it. So for instance, the cars that she's drawn and stuff like that, that will give you Wheel Kirby, and right here I believe was Microphone Kirby. So that would have done a decent amount of damage if I had actually gotten it, but yeah. I'm not sure if that actually gives you Crash Bomb or not. We will never know now. That is Spark right there, like if you couldn't tell by dropping the Thunderbolts and stuff, but... Yeah, this boss is kind of more difficult because a lot of it comes down to luck in terms of what she actually draws that can or can't help you out, really. So I'm going to shock her, get out of the way. And yeah, she also has a kind of random jumping pattern, if you couldn't tell that. That's kind of difficult to deal with, and she's fast! Okay, I don't mind dying to this boss as much as dying to Wispy Woods, because, you know, honestly, she can be a bit of a pain. Well, this time, we're gonna get her. I don't like my defensive ability, so gonna hit with that. Ooh, here we have Ball Kirby. Actually, one of my favourite abilities in the game, even though a lot of people don't really like it. Here it is. And Kirby will get an entire spin-off based off Ball Kirby. And basically, you just have to time your press or jump, and Kirby can actually do damage. But unfortunately, it's kind of limited in its use. Kirby can just roll around like this, which is pretty fun. Like, if you see Kirby glowing, then he will do damage, but there's a lot of times where Kirby as a ball just will get hit and he's kind of useless. But Wheel Kirby is, like, kind of like Ball Kirby. Just kind of more powerful, but even so, I've already talked about Wheel Kirby being kind of weak in certain situations, and I'm just going to go over here. I think it's just the randomness of her moving around, really, that sort of throwing me off, like, right there. Like, she just knows, like, the sort of exactly where to jump to just to throw you off, you know? I'm just gonna go up there. Okay, I think two more hits and she'll be done, and let's suck up Kirby. Oh, one more hit. Right. Okay, so thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in level 3.